We want to find the limit as x approaches 0 of the square root of the quantity x plus 1 minus 1 divided by x.
To determine this limit means to find the value the function approaches as x approaches 0 from the left side and the right side.
And for this limit to exist, that function value must be the same from the left side and right side of 0. Notice if we try to perform direct substitution to find this limit, we would have 0 divided by 0, which is an indeterminate form of a limit. So to see if this limit exists, let's start by graphing this function. So here's the graph of our function. Here's x equals 0. And so we want to approach 0 from the left side and right side to see if we approach the same function value. And we can tell graphically we are approaching the same function value, even though this graph does have a hole at x equals 0, which means the function does not exist at x equals 0, the limit does still exist. And we can actually tell it looks like it will be positive 1/2. But if we want to find this limit analytically, we'll have to manipulate this function so that we can perform direct substitution to find this limit. So to find this limit, we'll have to rationalize the numerator, which means we'll multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the numerator, which means we'll multiply the top and bottom by the square root of the quantity x plus 1 plus 1. So let's go ahead and do that. So again, we're multiplying both the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the numerator. When we do this, we're going to leave the denominator in factored form, and we'll go ahead and multiply out the numerator. So we'll have the limit as x approaches 0. Again, we'll leave the denominator in factored form, so we'll have x times the quantity square root of x plus 1 plus 1. And now in the numerator, we'll have four products. First product is the square root of x plus 1 times the square root of x plus 1, which will simplify to just one factor of x plus 1. And then we have the square root of x plus 1 times 1, which would be plus square root of x plus 1. But then notice how we have negative 1 times the square root of x plus 1. So then we have minus square root of x plus 1. Notice how these two terms are opposites, which should always be the case when multiplying conjugates. And then finally we have negative 1 times positive 1, which is negative 1 or minus 1. Now we'll go ahead and simplify the numerator. Again, these two terms are opposites. This is going to be equal to the limit as x approaches 0 of, notice in the numerator we have x plus 1 minus 1, which just simplifies to x, and the denominator stays the same. But notice how now we have a common factor of x between the numerator and denominator, which simplifies to 1. So now we have the limit as x approaches 0 of 1 divided by the square root of x plus 1 plus 1. And now we can find this limit by performing direct substitution. We would just have 1 divided by, well, if x is 0, this is the square root of 1 plus 1. So this simplifies nicely to 1/2, which is our limit. Notice how once we perform the substitution, we drop the limit notation here. And if we go back to our graph just for a moment, we were correct when we assumed that as we approach 0 from the left and right, we were approaching the function value of 1/2. I hope you found this example helpful.